What's up, everybody? Derek here, and I am down here at the river, or maybe what used to be left of the river. As you see, there's little pools back in behind me. There's roots of these old roots where the channel was and everything. And it's kind of, the water table has stopped flowing, so it's gotten so low that it's basically, I'd be like 2-3 foot underwater right now in this shallow section of what's usually flowing. So I'm gonna go down through here and see exactly what I can catch in these little holes. I don't know what I'm gonna use. It could be a Beetlespin. I haven't even looked in my tackle box yet. So we're gonna tie something on and see what we can catch. So let's get to fishing. All right, I got a Beetlespin tied on here with a little black grub on it. And looks like there's three little pools down through here. Nothing's flowing. So if there's any fish trapped in here, I'm thinking they're gonna eat. Oh, first cast, I already had a bite. It's not a bad looking little hole right here. Oh, our first fish right there. Smacked it. We got redbreast. Nice. Thanks, buddy. Fish. Oh, redbreast smacked it again. A little bit better of one, not that big, but at least we're catching them over there. Seems like they're off those roots in that deeper little spot. Oh, one hit it as soon as it hit the water. Oh, little bass. Came off when he jumped. Oh, I had another hit right there. Come on. Yeah, they're over there in that deeper spot. Oh, as soon as they hit the water. Is that a bass? That was a bass. That was a decent sized bass too. Oh, I had one as soon as it hit the water. Oh, that's a bass. Don't come off. Don't come off. Yeah, those bass are over there in that corner. Nice. Is that a Guadalupe? Yep, that's a Guadalupe bass right there. Man, these things are aggressive, but it's crazy. These things usually are in really good current areas, and now they're in a pond, basically. Let's go up to the next spot. I mean, look at how dry this is. So dry. Looks deeper right here, so it could be some decent bass in here. Oh, one hit it right on the bank. Oh, little bitty paint. Oh, is that a warmouth? Let's see. Come here, buddy. Whoa. Dang. A little bass right there just scared the crap out of me coming up shallow. Warmouth, look at that little guy. No, that's a red ear. See the little red right there? Now that's cool. So there's red ear in here. Man, that bass scared the crap out of me. He came up and hit top water right next to me. Let's see if he'll hit right here. Oh, there's some gar in here. Oh, there's a fish right there. What we got? Is that a warmouth or a red ear? Wow, that's a cool fish right there. That's a warmouth, I believe. Nice. Catching some species right now I don't usually catch a lot of the time. So that's definitely a warmouth. Thanks, buddy. Got one. one right there. And this is a pretty one. Green sunfish. Well, let's see. No, that's a, can't think off the top of my head right now. Let me know in the comments, Kai, what this is. Ah, he almost jumped it. Well, anyways, he's gone. What fish was that? Because I can't think off the top of my head. Pumpkin seed, I believe. Oh, got one right there. Whatever that is. There's a lot of panfish in these little pools. I'm just not really catching as many bass as I'd like, but oh well, I'm catching fish. Oh, let go of it, buddy. Got you good. There we go. Green sunfish. Just. Oh, I got something right there. What do I got? What do I got? Is this a red ear or a warmouth? Warmouth. Man, there are a ton of warmouth in here. I love it. Oh, oh, buddy, buddy. Get on out there. Got one. Is that another warmouth? This is... Oh, no. Well, red ear. Red ear and warmouth on this end. This is nice. I don't usually catch a lot of red ear or warmouth, so yep, red ear right there. Thanks, buddy. Oh yeah, last second little bass. Man, this is a pretty bass too. Come here, buddy. Nice. That's cool. Thanks, buddy. Whoa. Bad toss on my part. Well, I gave it a try at these little pools like what's behind me all up and down this river. And the Beetlespin came through. I caught more warmouth and red ear than I normally catch, which was kind of cool. So they're in these pools and little pockets, so to catch those was definitely a fun trip to come down here. I did catch a couple bass right there on those roots right behind me. It seems like they were loaded up, but really I didn't see a whole lot of bass that were really that hungry. But thanks for watching, you guys, and subscribe if you haven't already. Like this video if you liked it, and I'll see you guys in the next one.